Let's face it, we take a lot of pictures, and most of them are of ourselves. A study estimates that on average, a millennial will take 25,000 selfies in their lifetime. It's easy when everything's a camera. That doesn't mean that they'll all be posted, shared, and seen. A similar study found that on average, millennials will take 7 minutes to get that selfie just right. And if posting the average 9 selfies a week, that's 54 hours a year curating our public face. We're careful on what we post and we present the image we want to be seen. Was it always this way? Let's go back to the birth of photography. This is the earliest photograph ever. Made in 1826 by Joseph Nicéphore Naeff, it's of a French country house. You couldn't tell? But rapidly, the technology would advance, most notably with the daguerreotype developed by Naeff's partner, Louis Daguerreon. Officially unveiled in 1839, the previous year, Daguerreon would take the first photograph of a human, albeit he didn't mean to. He was taking a shot of a Parisian street. Since upwards of 10 minutes was needed for the image to be exposed, all other living beings disappeared except for this one man who stopped to get his shoes shined. The daguerreotype became the world's first commercially successful photographic process due to its relative speed, accurate detail, and the French government making the technology free and open to all. Except England. The Brits would have to pay a fee. Across the Atlantic, Americans fell in love with photography, and soon hundreds of daguerreotype studios opened. So that begs the question, who was the most photographed American of the 1800s? Abraham Lincoln? He certainly can be thought of as the most identifiable of the century, but scholars have only documented 126 distinct photos. Walt Whitman boasted, "No man has been photographed more than I have," and he certainly is a contender with 130 different portraits. Red Cloud's total stands at 127, U.S. Grant in the 150s, and Custer at 155. Figures like Mark Twain and Buffalo Bill Cody may reach as high as 850, but many are likely engravings, lithographs, or taken in the 20th century. According to the current count, the most photographed American of the 1800s, with 116 known photographs, was also one of the country's most influential figures. And he also started his life in the most oppressive of environments. He is Frederick Douglass. Frederick Douglass was born in Maryland sometime in the year 1818. Much of his early life was spent in the home of the plantation owner. There, he was taught to read and write by the slaveholder's wife despite laws against it. When these lessons ended, he coaxed lessons from the local children. But soon Douglass was loaned out for various forms of labor to various men, some cruel, some less cruel, but all determined to keep Douglass enslaved. So in September of 1838, the same year that the first human was captured in a photograph, Douglass escaped his own captivity. Douglass settled in Massachusetts and began attending abolitionist meetings. In 1841, he was invited to speak at the Bristol Anti-Slavery Society and later at William Lloyd Garrison's Massachusetts Anti-Slavery Society. It was in this same year that the first surviving daguerreotype of Douglass was taken. As Frederick Douglass became an American icon through his speeches and his 1845 autobiography, Narrative of the Life of Frederick Douglass, he also fell in love with photography. The humblest servant girl may now possess a picture of herself such as the wealth of kings could not purchase 50 years ago. But even more than a democratic art, Douglass recognized it as a tool for the abolitionist cause. The popular image of African Americans was usually shaped in caricature, illustrations with exaggerated features meant to mock, demean, and reinforce the social structure. Even in photography, images of African Americans were often limited to depictions of them as subservient slaves. Douglass knew that the same medium used to support the old hierarchy could be used to destroy it. He sat for countless sessions with photographers, white and black, male and female, knowing that his image could be just as strong as his words. That is why, with few exceptions, Douglass made sure every portrait portrayed the same image. A poised, strong, defiant man, undeniably African-American, but even more undeniably, a man. He would use his unflinching visage to confront the great lie that slavery was built on. That the black race was naturally inferior to the white race. That blacks were less human than whites. Even as the Civil War raged, the 13th Amendment freed 4 million souls, the nation attempted to reconstruct itself, and he became an international icon, Douglass's expression remained the same, steadfast. It's fitting that the only time his resolute eyes were closed for a photograph were on his deathbed, his face relaxed and at peace, after a lifetime of fighting for the fulfillment of the most American of ideals, freedom, liberty, and equality. If you like this video, you should check out Picturing Frederick Douglass, an illustrated biography of the 19th century's most photographed American by John Stauffer. This isn't a sponsored video. I just think that this book is amazing. I picked it up while at the Boston Museum of African American History, and it's incredible. Not only does it include every known picture of Douglass, but other awesome images, and it tells the story of how Douglass used the medium to spread his message. I'll leave a link to it down in the description. And if you like this video, hit the button that lets me know. Leave a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe, because there's a lot to learn, and we're going to learn it together. Be safe, and I'll see you next time.